Azi avem un infotrip cu jurnaliști străini. Este al doilea infotrip pe care îl organizăm anul acesta. Au fost profund impresionați. Urmează să relateze prin diferite reportaje de frumusețile pe care le-au descoperit aici, astfel că turiștii din afara țării o să ne viziteze, cred, în număr mult mai mare în perioada imediat următoare sau în anii viitori.
Acțiunea de astăzi cu prezența jurnaliștilor acreditați sau o parte din jurnaliști acreditați la Parlamentul European reprezintă din nou un exemplu de parteneriat public-privat. Consiliul Județean, Ministerul Turismului și Asociația de Management. Din nou am reușit, spun eu, să completăm eforturile autorităților centrale și locale pentru a promova Delta Dunării în context european important pentru România, preluarea președinției europene, Uniunii Europene din ianuarie 2019.
It's not the first time that I'm in Romania because I live in Germany. I'm German, but my father has been part of the German minority in Romania. He came from Gimbolia, Hatzfeld, in the very west of the country. So when up till I was 18 or 20, I regularly spent my summer holidays in Romania for six weeks. But that's long ago. I mean, that's 30 years ago. And I came back in the 90s. That was the last time I was in Romania. And now I came back after this long break, and I have to say that this country has changed enormously.
In a good way or a bad way?
In an extremely good way. Okay. Because, you know, the streets that I saw were good, just to give you an example.
What about this area, the area we're in right now, the Danube Delta?
Yeah, that's the first time I'm here. I've read about it, but I've never seen it, and it's wonderful. I mean, it takes you out of everyday stress, you know. Just already the way down here is so relaxing to see the countryside passing by, you know, the green grass and the birds and the silence and the nice villages. So that was great, and of course the highlight was to go on the boat and to be within this wild, untouched nature.
You're gonna go home, write a story maybe, tell others about this area. What would be the one thing that you would remember for years?
Well, you know, I'm a political correspondent actually. Okay. So I try not only to see the tourism part of it, mm-hmm. but the political situation and the development of the country. And I think, Romania just now, in these days where we arrived, is in a very interesting, for us, interesting political situation with a lot of tension and a lot of positive and a lot of negative possibilities to come. It makes it interesting. It's, you know, it's a developing young nation with beautiful places and resorts, with a lot of problems and contradictions and full of future. So I just like to present to my readers a Romania that is not cliched, you know. It would be easy just to write about this fantastic resort here, mm-hmm. but it wouldn't draw the whole picture.
Would you say that tourism is affected by the political situation?
Well, the better the international reputation of Romania becomes, the more easy it is to attract tourism.
Would you come back here?
I would certainly come back here. But, you know, sometimes I get the feeling this is such a sensible balance that you have here in nature that you should be aware not to attract mass tourism too easy, too fast. So Romania should watch out what kind of tourism it's about to attract.
How do you like what you've seen so far?
Oh, it's stunning. I mean, you expect a lot, of course, when you come, when everybody's saying, oh, this is a pearl here, but it's much bigger than I expected. It's much more to see than I expected. And I love this sense of keeping the nature, which we can see everywhere. So trying to bring the tourists, but keep the nature the way it is. It's huge. It's really nice. It's and what I like the most is that you probably as a tourist, not me as a journalist, because we're in a big group, you can find your peace here. You can find wild nature, primary nature, the way it is.
You're gonna go back home and you're gonna write a story or tell your viewers a story. What would you write about?
Oh, I think we have a lot of prejudice when we talk about Romania. A lot of people, also in Slovenia, not just in Slovenia, don't really know Romania. What we know is Ceausescu and stuff like that. After that, you know, more or less nothing, except that you are in the European Union and stuff like that. So there's a lot to bring. I think that the pictures that we took are stunning. I mean, a lot of people wouldn't expect something like that in Slovenia, because in Slovenia, you know, there's nature is a big thing, very important thing. And I think this is the right place for Slovene tourists to come, definitely.
What would you think they would like to see or do in here?
We Slovenes like to just walk, you know, to enjoy the nature and the peace that you can find here. I think that's the most important thing. And I think a lot of Slovenians would love to explore the whole Romania, but I don't know whether they would come here if they wouldn't see it before on the television or in the newspaper on stuff like that. So yeah, it's I've been to a lot of places, you know, from Iceland to here, and this is one of the, yeah, I'll bring my family here, so you have me.
Mai mult decât atât, aceste infotripuri nu se referă doar la Delta Dunării. Avem acum un grup de turiști străini care, iată, i-am adus aici. La sfârșitul lunii iunie o să avem un alt traseu cu o altă grupă, cu un alt grup de ziariști, și o să mergem pe București, zona Brașovului, zona Sibiului. Deci o să acoperim toată țara, dar fără doar și poate, principalul nostru atu este Delta Dunării, pentru că această delta este unică, cum am spus, în Europa, nu are nimeni așa ceva și trebuie să profităm.